What's going on? Robert Teegarden back again with another Teegarden quick tip tutorial. Before I get started, as usual, I'd like to remind you, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, ring the bell for post notifications. I post content on the subject of filmmaking tips and business of being a creative. So if that's something that you're into, go ahead and hit that like button and do all the different things that'll make this thing go up. And welcome to the community. I'm glad that you're here. I hope you stick around for a long time. There's a plenty of videos for you to check out. Great educational value. Maybe sometimes I might make you laugh. And now I'd like to get into this video, which is how do I fix a failed render. A lot of you guys were really into me saying, how do you reset a failed render in Adobe Media Encoder? And a bunch of those questions in the comment section were geared towards how do I fix a render that has failed inside of Premiere. So that's exactly what we're doing here today. I'd like to go over a couple different ways that I fix my renders and give you guys a clue in terms of how I kind of move things around. Hopefully that'll help you out on your deadlines, on your renders, on your stress factor, on the anxiety that it takes for you to render and export a video that you've been working on for so long. Without further ado, let's start with an easy one here in Premiere. Now, the first thing I want to make sure that we do, you guys might recognize this video that I was working on a couple weeks ago. The first thing I want to make sure that you're doing here is setting in and out points. So I'll go ahead and give you kind of a collapsed version of this. If you see this kind of different colored version here and this little blue bracket on this side, and let's just create a different endpoint and a blue bracket on this side. So these brackets are my in and out point. And so first of all, I want you to set an in and out point here for your rendered projects. And secondly, I want to make sure that you actually render your sequence. Now, what does that actually mean? Rendering your sequence. Now, the thing that's going to happen here is it's going to pre-render. Premiere is going to pre-render, meaning write all of your effects, both in video and audio, make sure your transitions are smooth, all the different things that it takes for the processing power of your CPU and GPU to take your edit and play it back smoothly. That's what rendering does. Kind of a very simple viewpoint, simple explanation, but most of the time what you're going to see is some version of a red thing up here, right? Or if I just create a brand new sequence from this clip, you might see some type of yellow bar on the top. Now, if you see yellow or you see red, those are not rendered sequences, and you could potentially, not always, but you could potentially have an issue rendering and or exporting your sequence if you have your sequence in a non-rendered status, meaning it's not green. So again, just to recap, how do I solve that? I'm gonna go back and I set my in and out points on my sequence. I'm gonna go up to sequence setting here, and you see it says render in and out or render selection, okay? I can also simply just render effects in and out and render my audio. Now you'll see up here, render in and out. Next to that, I have shift plus the tilde key or the accent key, the accent key, which is underneath the quotation marks just next to your enter button. Now that's a custom key setting that I created in Premiere because I'm always rendering my sequences constantly. And instead of going up and clicking through menus, I just hit shift and the quotations mark. The apostrophe. That's what I was looking to say. It's an apostrophe. That's really what it is. So shift apostrophe is my key shortcut that I've created to render my sequence all the time. And as you'll notice, this particular sequence looks good to go. And I should be able to render it with no issues. However, point number two, sometimes you get in a situation where you have a fully rendered sequence, you have your in and out point set and everything is good, but for some reason, whether you're editing or not editing, whether you're exporting through Adobe Media Encoder or natively through Premiere, you still get a failed export and everything looks fine. Your render is good, everything's cool, you just can't figure out what it is. Now here's a little tip that I do. I'm gonna go back into Premiere, I'm gonna set my in and out point, I'm gonna go to the end of my sequence, I'm gonna go forward or backward one frame, forward or backward one frame, and extend my out point of my edit. Now I know this may seem minuscule, but for some weird reason, this trick works for me 9 times out of 10. 60% of the time, it works all the time. So I just simply move my edit point, or my out point one frame over, either forward or backwards, and I go ahead and I export my file, and most of the time, that's what fixes my failed renders. Just moving my endpoint out one frame, just my out point one frame. I also, this is point number three, I have duplicated that sequence and copied everything into a new sequence. I'll duplicate the sequence. I'll go up into my sequences over here, right? Go into this one. I'll go duplicate my sequence on this side, double click. I'll go ahead and delete everything inside that sequence. I'll go back into my other sequence, copy everything, go over to the beginning and paste it in. And a lot of the time, setting new in and out points, you'll see that that fixes your failed renders also. Okay, so I'm gonna move my endpoint out one frame, hit render, I should be good to go. If not, duplicate my sequence, copy everything into a new sequence, and I'm good to go there. Now here's one that's, I don't have to use this all the time, but when I have to do some crazy heavy lifting, here's another one that I'll use. I'll actually go ahead and create a brand new project, right? I'll create a brand new project, an untitled project. I'm gonna right click inside here and hit import. I'm gonna go through, find my project files, okay? And then I'm going to import a selected sequence. Now when I import a selected sequence, sometimes the dynamic link server takes a little bit to find where my sequences are, and that's okay because, you know, I just find something else to do, scroll through the Grom, or maybe post some funny weird stuff on Twitter, or, you know, whatever the social media platform is of your day. I still don't, the TikTok dancing stuff to me is just, maybe it's because I'm getting old, but, you know, I don't really understand it. Once all my sequences pop up from this particular window, I'll select the sequence that I was working on, import it into a brand new project, and I'm able to render and export my project from the newly created project file that I have here, importing my old sequence into that newly created project file. Sometimes this may be an issue where you have a corrupted project file and you need some reason to create a brand new project file so that your export will work fine. I don't really know exactly what the details are here. I'm just showing you solutions that have worked for me. So, you know, don't shoot the messenger. I'm just saying create a new project, import it into that sequence, and you should be good to go there as well. Now, last thing I want to show you guys is actually something that came from my partner in crime. With me as always is Garth Reese Deming, and he was telling me and reminded me that if I have After Effects sequences in my sequence file and After Effects isn't opened and those sequences aren't rendered, 9 times out of 10, we're gonna get a failed render that way as well, or a failed export, excuse me. So make sure if you're using any After Effects sequencing or any little parts of your sequence are going through After Effects, through the dynamic link or through Adobe Bridge, make sure that After Effects is open and those parts are rendered as well, and you should be good in terms of the failed export from that way. Now this one, I know this last one I'm gonna tell you guys, you're gonna give me a big old eye roll, and I hate when people do this too. Every time I call tech support in some weird way, they're like, have you shut off your computer and restarted? Have you saved your file? Have you done all this stuff? And I wanna reach through the phone and grab them and shake them by their neck and be like, I'm not tech stupid. I understand how technology works. And yes, I have restarted. And yes, I have opened my file up again. I'm still having this problem, but this time, sometimes that happens. Again, your cache memory, the RAM, everything kind of gets weird. Sometimes when you're working on a project for a long period of time, I know that I used to be guilty of just simply putting my computer to sleep and opening it back up and letting it go again. Sometimes you need to clear out all the stuff, hit reset, and just let it do its thing. So I'm gonna encourage you again, if all else fails, save your project, shut down your computer, don't restart it, shut it down, start that thing back up again, launch Premiere, and see if that actually works, right? So I don't know how many of those I just gave you, but there's a ton of value in this video, and I'm gonna wrap this thing up saying, if you like the video, like the damn video. We just gave you a whole bunch of ways that you can fix your failed exports in Premiere Pro. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, ring the bell for post notifications, and this has been Teegarden with another Teegarden quick tip tutorial, even though this one's not so quick. But you get the point. I'll see you in the next one. Peace!